Dr. Wannabe Miranda, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Dr. Vlogger. So I am officially starting a new series, and that is my doctor's POV series, my doctor's point of view. Yes, since I noticed how opinionated I am with a lot of things and how I sometimes love thinking and analyzing things and then share them to my friends, why not I share them to you guys? This is just a casual, a chill, a relaxed series that a doctor has decided to talk about a lot of topics, from medical, from personal, from family issues, from even mental well-being. So yeah, for the first episode, I have decided, why is being a doctor not for you? Let's face it, becoming a doctor is not for everyone. It takes a lot to become one. I know this. Most of you know this. Some reasons, of course, there are financial, situational reasons, personal reasons, and I'm going to just try to break them all down to you for this video. And these are just merely based on my own perspective, my own personal and then perhaps maybe professional perspective, since I have been there. Comment down below if you want to add to these reasons that I'm going to share to you. But before that, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Share the video if you want to. Click on that notification bell to be updated with my latest upload. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So first, of course, the reason that I can really think of is when you're in it for the wrong reasons. I mean, kahit naman hindi pagdo-doktor, kahit naman sa ibang mga profession, diba? You really have to be in it for the right reason. And in life, you always have to know the purpose of why you are doing such thing. And in being a doctor, you really have to know the purpose of why you are doing this. Because at the end of the day, when you are in it for the wrong reason, you will not be happy. You will continually seek for that validation, and you will continually seek for that answer of, why am I even doing this? Why am I still here? For example, you know what happened to us during this pandemic. There are a lot of doctors that have realized, did I really make the right decision in becoming one when I'm not even willing to join this pandemic? When I'm not even willing to be a doctor during this pandemic? So yeah, you have to really be in it for the right reasons in order for you to do the job and in order for you to stay and finish the journey. Like, for instance, you want to be a doctor because you want to be rich. Let me tell you, it's not always the case, guys. You want to be a doctor because of the prestige, the reputation of the title doctor. So, of course, included na yon. Bonus na din naman talaga yon. But hindi lang po ganun ka superficial ang dapat na alam nyo kung bakit yung gustong maging doctor. So, yeah, the second one that I can think of is when you have no teamwork. Being a doctor involves a very long process. It's a journey. You will have your pre-med, of course, and then medical student ka nin, maging intern ka, and PGI pa nga, postgraduate internship, magiging resident ka, then fellowship. Even when you become a doctor, you always have to value teamwork. You have to know how to follow, and then you also have to eventually know how to lead. And follow, kasi yun na nga, pag intern ka, minsan nag-joke pa kami noon ha, that we are at the bottom, nasa bottom kami ng cycle. Human cycle, like sa hospital. So you really have a lot of senior doctors, consultants, marami kang ibang follow. Besides the of course, the usual rules and regulations of a training, meron mga demands from you, may dapat kang gawin as an intern, of course, and then may encounter ka ng mga senior doctors na let you do stuff na minsan you will think that it's not fair. However, as long as you're not at risk and you're not putting a patient at risk, perhaps you have to know na lang, okay, there will be a reason why you're going to do such things na sinasabi ng senior doctors mo. So you have to know how to obey and how to follow. And especially when you're a resident. When you're a resident, being first year resident, second year, and third year, there will be a lot of times na you will wonder, is this even right? Yung mga gusto nilang ipagawa sa'yo, tama ba, napapagawa sa'yo. But then again, as long as like what I've said, wala ka namang mapapahamak at hindi ka mapapahamak, then you just have to learn how to follow. And then eventually, you will know why you did all those things. Because ako, based on my experience, when I was in first year, I actually thought that there was this unfair treatment. Yung mga ganong kadramahan ng first year ka. And then when I was in third year, I realized na I needed to go all through those things in order for me to gain the trust and confidence of all the consultants in the hospital. Part of teamwork is getting along with your co-residents, with your co-fellows. You will realize that they are the ones who will be able to help you in a lot of ways during residency training. You really have to value teamwork. You have to know how to listen. And if you're a resident now, and if you're even a medical student now, you will understand me when you reach to that level. So another reason is when you're not fully decided yet. Being a doctor is no joke. It's not a 3 years or 4 year course. Talagang sobrang dami niyang pagdadaanan, sobrang years that you will spend your time, minsan yung half of your life, in becoming one. So when you're not fully decided, when from the beginning you weren't really sure if becoming a doctor is what you want, especially when you just listen to your parents kasi doctor ang parents mo, or when your parents really wanted you to become a doctor, so sige na lang kasi andyan na yan, magiging result nun is you're not going to give your 100% sa pagiging doctor. So it will take a lot from you, your time, minsan your passion, you will not be able to do what you really love. And being a doctor, it will take a lot of your time and a lot of you. So you really have to be fully decided in order for you to say that everything or every sacrifice that you're going to make is worth it. You love art, you love creative stuff, then you're not going to be able to do that. But then if you committed or fully decided that you want to be a doctor, okay lang naman na hindi na muna magawa yun, because ginagawa mo naman din yung something that you also are decided and that you also love in doing. Based on my personal experience, it was my mom who wanted me to become a doctor, but then like what I said, I learned loving the profession. I learned that I actually love being a doctor. Everything that comes along with it, the cons and the pros. You really have to be fully decided. If not, then being a doctor is not or is still not for you. So another one is when you're easily discouraged. Being a doctor, sabi ko nga, pagdadaanan mo yung being the lowest form of human being. Intern, medical student, magiging PJ ka, magiging resident ka, first year, second year, third year, pagdadaanan mong lahat yon, and there will be a lot of times na mapagalitan ka, and then when you feel like you did everything that you could, pero mali pa din, iba-iba din yung personalities ng mga consultants. Of course, you will deal with a lot of personalities, different personalities and characters, not just from the consultants, from your seniors, but from the patients, different yung treatment from a private hospital and from a government hospital. You will encounter betrayals and kahit yung mga kabatch mo sa residency. I mean, you really have to be tough. What you can do is trust God, pray lang, and if you really love what you're doing, and then you will be able to survive. You will also even feel na minsan others will give you work na supposedly dapat work nila. I mean, those kind of stuff. You will encounter all those things, and then you just really have to pray and to believe in yourself during those times and decide kung ano ang pipiliin mong gagawin. If you just will follow them, or lulunukin mo na lang muna ba, titiisin mo na lang din, because these two shall pass. Siniisip ko, ang unfair naman nito, why am I doing all this work? But if ever that patient is involved, if ever a patient is involved, is going to benefit from what I'm going to do, kahit hindi ko naman siya work, I'll just think na sige, I'm going to do this because of this, because of the patient, because may mga be-benefit naman siya other than my senior, other than me. There are a lot of things that have to be weighed in and a lot of factors, and I know sometimes hindi ka na din makakaisip kasi pagod ka na. You really just have to have this tough and strong character, be responsible, hard work as well. So another factor that I included is being impatient. Let us just admit that there are personalities that are impatient. diba? So when you're impatient and you want to earn, especially money matters, and we understand that, you want to earn ASAP, you want to earn as soon as possible, hindi po para sa inyo ang pagiging doktor. Because pagiging doktor is delayed gratification. Kung hindi po kayo sa sweldo agad, dami pang years na ikaw pa nga mismo minsan ang gagastos. Based on my personal experience ngayong residency training ko, it was my allowance during those times not enough. Sometimes we still need the help of our parents. Sometimes may mga siblings pa na yun ang tumutulong sa kanila. When you're impatient, especially with regards to money, with income, and mga benefits in becoming a doctor, hihintayin mo pa din talaga siya. So you have to develop the value in waiting, in hoping for the good, and in surviving the journey in becoming a doctor. The practical reasons, the more practical reasons are those financial reasons. I have a friend na talagang gusto niya talaga mag-doctor, but incapable of the financial aspect of becoming one, so hindi niya din nagawa, and as of now, hindi din talaga siya naging doctor. But everything happens for a reason. Financial reason is one. It's a given. I'm not going to expound on that. And another one is situational factors, situational reasons. Like, may mga ibang during medical school who met the love of their life and realized that family is what they want or what their priority is. So, inuna nila yon, nagpakasal, and then eventually, hindi na din naging doktor. So, yeah, guys, that is going to be my episode 1 of my new series, The Doctor's Point of View. Or, can I call it Doctor Vlogger's Point of View? Since it's my branding. So any suggestions, guys, you can comment down below sa title natin sa series na to. I haven't really decided one yet, but watch out for my next episode. And please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, share my video, and just comment down below whatever it is that you want to express or to suggest na mga topics that we're going to be able to talk about. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.